the main resource for a cancer patient is his or her oncologist. And so we go to see the oncologist, and the oncologist says, here's the progression, here's a new medication, here's a new treatment, whatever it is, and then you leave. And you think, who do I talk to about intimacy issues? Who do I talk to about financial issues? Who do I talk about with spiritual issues? Where do I go for any of this? And if you're not willing to ask, whether it's denial, embarrassment, you don't have a lot of time with your oncologist. I think a lot of us sometimes feel like we're on a bit of a clock when you're in there. Who do you ask? And the priority right now is staying alive. So sometimes that stuff just goes to the wayside. We just don't have time for it. And so I found a hospice program that I attend, and through the hospice residents, they offer counseling, totally covered. So I can go in and talk about anything that I want. And the counselor asked about my husband. And I said, well, he'd probably benefit from this. We have a pretty strong foundation, but talking about different, maybe if you suggest different cancer side effects or issues that we don't necessarily think about or talk about or know to ask about. And so my husband and I go maybe about once a month, and we just talk about things. We've worked through things. We've been going for a few months. We've worked through things we didn't even know were on our plate to work through. And it has been so helpful. And it's just somebody kind of guiding the conversation. There isn't any, you know, deep therapy to it. It's just kind of asking questions, and we end up talking about things that we didn't even know were a priority to both of us. And I talk to so many people who don't know that's available. And again, who I don't know where that falls. I think a palliative doctor is willing to send a requisition to somebody, but I don't know where the obligation or the responsibility falls. Is it up to the patient to come up with some of these things? Sometimes we don't know that these resources exist. Sometimes we don't know that this is an issue. Oh, I just thought everybody dealt with this. Or do we wait for oncologists to ask? Because often the oncologist, the focus is the cancer. And in my case, I like that. I want her to just deal with my cancer, and I'll get the support from the other places. But there's a disconnect between how do we know who to ask, and how do we know something exists if we don't know why it exists? How do we know to ask these questions and these specialists if we don't know that it's an issue?